Good morning, children. In the previous session, we started a new lesson in history, that is Unit 2, Early Humans. So in this lesson, we studied about the Stone Age. Can you recall what is meant by Stone Age? Yes. The early humans started to use stone for making their tools, and therefore this period in the human history is known as the Stone Age. The Stone Age can be divided into three periods based on the quality of stones they used. They are the Paleolithic period, Mesolithic period, and Neolithic period. And we also studied about some of the features of the Paleolithic period in the previous session. We studied about how they gathered food, about their clothing, shelter, and the tools they used. In today's session, we will study about the tool-making techniques of the early humans, that is, how they made their own tools. And next we will study about how these early humans discovered fire, their art, and the major Paleolithic sites. We will also study about the Mesolithic period. And at the end we will have a case study on the Deccan. Tool making techniques. We studied that the early humans used stone tools. Some of the tools are also made of the bones of the animals. They used the tools such as spears and arrows for hunting the animals, to cut the roots and fruits, and also to scrap the bark of the trees. Now let us see how these early humans made these tools. The remnants of the tools found show that they could have been made by two techniques. Remnants means the left out part. So the left out part of the tools which have been found are said to be made of two techniques. They are the stone on stone technique and pleasure flaking technique. Stone on stone technique. In this technique, the stone which has to be reshaped is held in one hand and the other stone is held on the other hand and it is used as a hammer. We all know that hammer is a tool which is used for shaping and breaking. The second stone, that is the hammer stone, was stuck on the core in a manner to break away the parts of the stone and give the desired shape to the core stone and make it into a tool. Here the core stone is the stone which has to be reshaped. So the hammer stone is stuck on the core stone to break away the unwanted parts and to make it into a tool. So this technique is called as the stone on stone technique. The second method in tool making technique is pressure flaking. It is a method of trimming. Trimming means to make something neat by removing the unwanted parts. So it is a method of trimming the edge of a stone tool by removing small stony flakes. Stony flakes means very small particles, unwanted particles. So they do this trimming by pressing on the stone with a sharp stone rather than striking it. So instead of striking over the core stone, they just use a sharp stone and press over the core stone. We have already studied what is meant by the core stone. The stone which has to be reshaped is called as the core stone. Discovery of fire. Now let us see how the early humans discovered fire. It is assumed means it is guessed or believed that the fire must have been discovered by accident. It is likely that early humans would have rubbed two stones together and a spark would have been created and burnt the dry leaves. So this is what led to the discovery of fire by the early humans. So this discovery of fire was one of the most important discovery in the history of humans. The concept of fire was very new to the early humans. Slowly and gradually, they started to learn how to make use of the fire. Here are some of the ways in which early humans used fire. They used the fire to cook meat before eating. And they lit fire outside their caves to protect themselves from wild animals. They kept themselves warm with the help of the fire in the cold weather. Art. Early humans painted on the walls of the caves, and these cave paintings of the early humans are still found in Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh. And these sites, that is the sites where the paintings of the early humans are found, are considered as the World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Heritage means honorable. The full form of UNESCO is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. The paintings of the early humans gives us some idea about their way of life. Most of the paintings depicts, that is, it represents the scene of hunting, people dancing, playing round drums, wounded animals, people riding animals like elephant, bison, horse, tiger, wild boar, animals fighting, and so on. In one of the paintings, man has shown riding on a horse. The early humans had used mainly white and red color in order to color their drawings. They have also used green and yellow color in some places. From where do they get these colors? Any idea? According to the scientist point of view, they believe that colors were prepared by combining charcoal, redstone, and powders from other stones. Charcoal means black carbon residue, which is left out after burning wood or animal bones. The paintings have survived for so many years and the colors have not faded till now. That is, the paintings of these early humans existed in this earth so many years and even the colors were not faded till now. It is really surprising, isn't it? Major Paleolithic sites. We have already studied that early humans settled down in places where there is good sources of water, like rivers, lakes, etc. Now we will study about the major Paleolithic sites. A site is a place where some stone tools belonging to early humans are found. Most Paleolithic sites are located near the areas where good quality stones are available and which were close to sources of water like lakes, rivers, etc. So most of the Paleolithic sites have been found where there is good quality of stone and where there is a good sources of water like rivers, lakes, etc. A number of Paleolithic sites have been found in places like Hunsky and Kurnool near River Krishna, riverbeds of Son River in Punjab, which is now in Pakistan, Kashmir Narmada Valley, etc. Since early humans lived in these areas, they are also called the habitation sites. Habitation means the fact of living in a particular place. Mesolithic period. In Greek language, the word meso means middle. So therefore, Mesolithic period is also known as the Middle Stone Age. This Mesolithic period lasted from 10,000 to 8,000 BCE. The Mesolithic period was the period between the Paleolithic and Neolithic period. In the Mesolithic period, the climate changed and it became warm and dry. So due to this climatic changes, there was changes in the environment also. As a result, the human beings moved from one place to another. This Mesolithic period is also called as the transitional phase between the Paleolithic age and Neolithic age. Transitional means changing from one state to another. Features of the Mesolithic period. During this Mesolithic period, the humans learned to make better tools. These tools were more delicate as compared to the tools of the Paleolithic age. That is, even though they made better tools, but it was not as strong as the tools of the Paleolithic period. They made flake tools such as scrapers and knives. Flake tools means it is a very thin and flat tool. Scrapper is a tool which is used for removing unwanted matter from a surface. The humans of the Mesolithic period also started to make smaller and sharper tools which were called as the microliths. We already know that micro means very small or tiny. So microliths are tiny razor-like flakes that were fitted into the wooden shaft of an arrow or spear. So these microliths are fitted to the wooden shaft of an arrow or spear. There is archaeological evidence. Archaeology is the study of human history or prehistory, and there is archaeological proof to show that flint blades are the blades which are made of hard rocks and they are considered to be very sharp. These flint blades were used to provide the tip of arrows. Since these flint blades are very sharp, they are fitted to the handles of wood or bone and they formed the cutting parts of various types of tools. Humans continued to be food gatherers in the early part of this age, but towards the later part, humans began to grow crops and they started to domesticate animals. That is, during the early part of the Mesolithic period, the humans were only food gatherers. They don't know how to grow crops. But at the later part of the Mesolithic period, they started to grow crops and they started to have domestic animals. Neolithic period. The Neolithic period is also called as the New Stone Age. It lasted from 8000 to 4000 BCE. The word neo means new in Greek language, and this is the last period of the Stone Age. We will read about this in detail in the next chapter. Deccan, a case study. The Deccan Plateau is one of the oldest plateaus of the Indian subcontinent. First, we have to know what is meant by a plateau. A plateau is a flat area of land that is elevated above sea level. Subcontinent means it is the subdivision of a continent. We all know that India is located in the Asia continent. So Indian subcontinent means India is said to be a subdivision of the Asia continent. This Deccan Plateau is a large plateau that covers most of the South India. It is triangular. On the west of this Deccan Plateau is the Western Ghats, and on the east you have the Eastern Ghats. The Deccan Plateau has many rivers flowing from the western edges towards the Bay of Bengal. This region has a warm climate and rocky surfaces. It also has huge stretches of forest, and because of all these factors, the people of the Stone Age settled in these places to find food, water and shelter in comfortable temperature. Many sites of human settlements of the early Stone Age people have been found spread over the different parts of the Deccan Plateau. So there are evidence for the settlement of the Stone Age people in these Deccan Plateau. Most of these are nearby the rivers and their tributaries. Tributaries means smaller river or stream which joins the main river. One such site where archaeologists have found many signs of Stone Age habitation is Hunsgi. This site is close to Krishna River. Hunsgi is located in North Karnataka. Some localities at Hunsgi, Isampur and Ediyappur were excavated systematically. Excavated means remove earth carefully from in order to find the buried remains. Artifacts. Artifacts are something made by man. Artifacts which are recovered from the Deccan Plateau includes hand axes, cleavers, scrapers and knives. And these artifacts have the characteristic of the Paleolithic and Mesolithic age. The limestone is considered to be an important stone for making tool. The other raw material for making tool are granite, basalt and shale. Small amounts of fossils of wild cattle, horse, elephant and deer are found in some localities around the Deccan region. So children, we have completed the lesson. So in this lesson we studied about the early humans. Early humans are those human beings who lived 4 to 5 million years ago. This period is also called as the Stone Age. It is said to be Stone Age because they started to use stones for making their tools. And therefore, this period in the human history is also known as Stone Age. The Stone Age can be divided into three periods based on the quality of stones. They are Paleolithic period, Mesolithic period, and Neolithic period. Paleolithic period is also called as the Old Stone Age. It lasted from 5 lakh to 10,000 BCE. Mesolithic period is also called as the Middle Stone Age, and it lasted from 10,000 to 8,000 BCE. And the Neolithic period is called as the New Stone Age, which lasted from 8,000 to 4,000 BCE. Under the Paleolithic period, we studied about how the people in those period gathered food, about their clothing, place of living, tools, tool making techniques, discovery of fire, art, and the major Paleolithic sites. Next, we studied about the Mesolithic period. During this period, humans started to make better tools. They also started to make smaller and sharper tools. At the later period of the Mesolithic age, the humans started to grow crops and they started to raise domesticated animals. Neolithic period. And about this Neolithic period, we will learn in more detail in the next chapter. We had a case study on Deccan. The archaeologists have found many signs of the Stone Age habitation in the Deccan region. So in the next chapter, we will study in more detail about the Neolithic period. Thank you, children.